Okay, so what we're doing here is that we want to multiply values at each location across two layers. And so that's really what I'm going to show you how to do. This is our particular case. This is the general idea. And then because I'm showing you how to do this across two layers, I also want to do kind of an intro to ArcMap, which is kind of the third musketeer of the ArcGIS. And before we do this, I also want to show you how to kind of download data from the course website, because I've got a data set there that would be nice to look at in ArcMap. So let's do this part first by opening up a browser and then typing in GoGIS is fun. And that should take you to this index of GIS datasets. And what I'd like you to grab is this thing that's called lab1zip. And I think if you double click on it, or just single click on it, it'll come in. And then you just can click there. And then you can extract all these files. And let's just go ahead and navigate to our working directory that we'd set up, which is called lab1. Say OK, then say extract. It might be a little redundant now we've got lab1 in lab1, but that's okay. There's some good stuff in here. So now what I'd like to do is close all this, and I'm going to shut that down, and let's go ahead and open up ArcMap. So when it's your first time opening up ArcMap, you probably got this GUI here, and down in the lower left it said something like never show me this again, and I usually kind of click that and then say okay, because I don't think that's a very helpful welcome banner. I find it actually kind of tiresome over time. So ArcMap is where you compose maps. So let's start composing. You'll see that you can access ArcToolbox and the search, and then also ArcCatalog, all from within ArcMap. So let's go ahead and get ArcCatalog. And it comes in just like Toolbox did, and once we move it around, we can drag it and drop it over there. Now, I usually kind of go through my startup routine whenever I bring in ArcCatalog, so make sure that my folder connection is connected to my working directory. If it's not, you're going to just have to right-click, connect to folder. It's going to be just like what we did, kind of what we did over here in ArcCatalog, we can now do over here, and now do have this reserved for ArcMap. Do you remember the two other things that I did that I'd encourage you to do? One was to go to Geoprocessing Options and to make sure that that is not enabled. And the other is to go up here and go into Environments and make sure that the workspace is set up to our GDB and the Scratch workspace as well. And so once that's all set up, let's go over here, and I'm just gonna refresh this because I thought I stuck my refresh. There it is. So this is the data that I grabbed from the website. And so let's go ahead, and I'm going to click on this egg carton and hold it down and drag and drop it over here. And there's our campus. So we're on our way to making a map. And the next thing I want to do is grab my first raster. And I want to drag and drop this so that it layers over that image. And it should come right in. Say OK. Now, it should line up perfectly. And if it doesn't, you'll have to tell me why. If these corners aren't square on yours and exactly kind of touching those, you'll have to tell me why. And then I'd like you to fix that if you would. Right, but we've got our kind of real world with all its beautiful detail, and then we've got our highly abstract and generalized world of a raster. But it's our first raster, so we're just trying to kind of get a feel for how these things work. And so the next thing I'd like you to do is I'd like you to make this. So I'll give you a hint. I started by basically making a new text file raster, and then I created this raster using that same tool. And I accessed the tool right there, Right. So I could access it directly within ArcMap. You don't have to go back to our catalog to be able to do this. And then in terms of how I made this second raster, the header is going to be the same. The difference is going to be the array of value, the grid of values underneath that header. And so if we grab this little kind of information booth sign and start poking around, you'll see that everything in this grid has the value 1. Everything down here has the value 12. Everything here has the value 7. So can you see how the numbers have to kind of align in the text file in order to make this? So if so, give it a shot. If you need some help, call someone over, but hit pause and make this raster, please. Okay, so I'm going to uncheck that guy so that the campus image is not on, and then check that guy so that I'm looking at the parking zones on top of my first raster, right? And what I'd like you to do then is grab this you know, the information booth, and click somewhere, and then let's make this not topmost, but let's make visible. And so what this is going to do now when I use it is it's going to tell you the value at th at you know, so let's start here. So that uppermost pixel has the value 1 in parking zones and 0 in my first raster. Now let's actually move this and drag and put the my first raster on top of the parking zones. And now let's click on this guy, right? So that parking zones is still there. It's just underneath this guy. So now let's click on this green one, and it's telling me that it was 1 here and that it's in the 4 zone underneath, right? Because it overlaps with the red. So over here, it's 1 in the 2 zone, and here, it's 1 in the 5 zone, and so on, right? And so what I'd like to show you now how to do is you're going to use a tool that for every location in this raster, and for basically every location in both rasters, it's going to multiply the value of this cell times the corresponding value of that cell. Does that make sense? I think I might have mangled that, but it's starting to get a little late, and I'd like to run through this. So let me just show you how this is going to be done. We're going to use a tool called Raster Calculator because we're basically just doing simple math here. It's just multiply. And so we're going to use, hold on a sec. So we're going to use Raster Calculator, and we're going to get this buzzkill, unable to execute the selected tool, blah, blah, blah. There's no license currently available or enabled, and that's the kind of the key term there. So we actually have this license, we just don't have it enabled right now because the default is for it. Okay, thanks, I got it. You didn't like that request. So if you go up here and go to extensions, these are all of the kind of additional functions that Middlebury has kind of acquired on top of the base functionality of ArcGIS. And we're asking to use a tool from Spatial Analyst, right? Spatial Analyst, it's an extension. If we brought in ArcToolbox, you'll notice that there's a toolbox called Spatial Analyst. And in here, there's a bunch of tools. These are basically most of these tools, I think all of these tools deal with rasters. And so, anyway, if you get that message, you just have to kind of make sure that you go up here and tell Arc that you're going to be using the license that we have for Spatial Analyst. And now, when I click on this, I should have no issues at all. And what I'd like to do is basically any layer that's in my table of contents is going to appear here. And so I should be able to just double-click on that, say times, and then double-click on this. And now I just like to give it a better name. And so I'll go into here, and this is going to be, I'm sorry for but just this mouse really seems to be kind of flickering a lot. I hope that's not too distracting. Anyway, so this is going to be the third thing that we did, and it's going to be the multiply. I'm going to say save. Okay. And so, what did that get us? Did you see what that got us here? It got us what? What do you think all of these kind of beige gray colors represent? What value do you think these are? What would be your guess? What do they look like? Right? They kind of look like the black values. So if we grab this identify tool and we can have this on again, we can say, okay, so in, see if I can get some real estate here. So in this new thing we made, this value is 0. In my first raster, it's 0. And in my parking zones, it's 1. So in the first parking zone, this was no parking. And that's what it's telling us. So do you see what we wound up just doing? We basically, for every place that is a parking, we just wound up picking the kind of the ID of the parking zone up by multiplying this true or false raster against a raster that showed the ID of the parking zones, right? And so now it's not just that it's true that it's parking, but it's telling you which zone this parking location is in. Does that make sense? So let's clean this up a little bit and then go back here and say, okay, that's what we did, like technically, we multiplied, but you know, the reason why we did that was to basically find the parking zone IDs, right? Or identifiers. Can I just write that? They're unique numbers for each, you know, parking location. Does that make sense?